Now this one has been on our list for quite a while, but now it's time. Let's fly like Harry Styles. Jordy here for CineCamp.net and welcome to Copycat Friday! Now, today's video is sponsored by Videoblocks, a library where you can download stock clips, video effects, templates, and a lot more. Now, one of the things you can get from their site are beautiful sunsets, which we'll use as our background later in the video. I could try out many of these different backgrounds as my year subscription allows for unlimited downloads every day. Get a 7-day trial for free by clicking in the first link in the description below. If you haven't seen Sign of the Times from Harry Styles yet, definitely do. It's pretty impressive how they've made Harry fly. They've actually attached him to a helicopter and removed the cable and post. And that's why his flying looks so natural. He's actually in that space, no visual effects nor green keying. Unfortunately, we couldn't arrange that helicopter, but I do want to try the same ID on a green screen. The first thing that we need to do is figure out a way to attach ourselves securely to a cable. We first tried to lay in a swing, but the post that I'm in doesn't look quite natural. Just like Harry Styles, I needed a harness so that the cable can be attached on my back. Jannik has a friend who does rock climbing and he let us borrow his climbing harness. The rope needs to be attached somewhere above you. We threw it over a beam in our studio. You could also throw it over a branch, but make sure it's strong enough. The harness is actually a pants, but since I needed the cable to be attached on my back, I put it on like a shirt. It wasn't too comfortable, but it worked. Once everything sits in place, make sure to test it out first and that everything is secure. Next up is the green screen. Make sure it's big enough so that you'll fit completely in the green area. As for the lighting, make sure it's evenly distributed. Since we had a lot of daylight coming through a dome, we had a very soft overall lighting, which was perfect. By the way, if you want to learn all the nifty details on how to set up and pull off the perfect green screen, then make sure to click in the cart up there. And once that was set up, we focused on the lighting for the subject. It's best that you know which background clips that you'll be working with up front. We went for some sunset clips from Videoblocks, so to match the lighting of that, we placed a big tungsten light in the back. And now we're ready to swing! We did find out though that it wasn't so easy to get a natural flying pose. I guess humans just aren't so natural with flying. You kinda wanna let yourself hang, but at the same time trying to keep your balance in the air. After a couple of shots, it's time to bring it into Premiere Pro. First, let's remove the green. Under opacity, I create a mask and draw inside the green screen. Then I apply the Ultra Key effect to it to remove all the green. If you want to see an in-depth tutorial on how the Ultra Key works, you can click any card again up there. Next up, I position myself where I want to be, but here comes the tricky part. You kind of want to blend in with the background to make it look realistic. And the first thing you could do is color grading. From the Lumetri panel, I make myself darker, add some more orange into the shot, and under the Creative tab, increase the faded film to get rid of the harder contrasts. Now, since I put myself in the far distance, it's not so natural that I look too sharp. So I'll add a simple Gaussian blur and set the blurriness to something around 40. So that is going to help. But it still might not look really natural, and that's because of the movement. I think this is one of the trickiest things to do. I also don't think that we got it all right, but it basically comes down to adjusting a lot and trying to look for unnatural errors. So here's what we're going to do. For the background, I'm going to set the scale to 200%, and that allows me to move the position to one end, create a keyframe, and move the frame to the other end of the clip. What we basically have now is a pan movement. And I'll do the exact same thing with myself. And after the keyframes have been placed, I click on the motion property, which will reveal the path of the position animation. To make it less static, I pull the levers on the start and stop keyframe. That way, I kind of float more. You can also move your last keyframe a little higher in an arc like this, so that it seems like you're flying up. However, this should be a conscious choice. You can see that I'm also looking up, changing my arms and feet. So this pose would match with that I would suddenly fly faster or higher. And this is that part that I was talking about, which is so hard to do. You constantly want to change your path, the speed of the animation, etc. Now, if you are still having trouble like us to get it right, there's actually a little trick. Select the two clips, right-click on it, and say Nest. We now have the two clips in a group, and on that group, I will apply a fake camera movement. I'm using the one from Jarl, which is actually a free preset, and I'll leave a link to his preset in the description below. Since we have a camera movement now on both of the clips, the individual movements are now a little bit covered up. And we can do the same thing with the color grading. If you had trouble matching the colors, you could apply an overall grading to the group. A last problem that I was running into was that the backgrounds had more noise because I scaled it up. My clip had almost no digital noise because I was scaled down. So from the effects, I searched for noise and applied it also to the group. Disable color noise and increase the amount a tiny bit. So that was it for blending ourselves into a stock clip from VideoBlocks. Lastly, we need to remove the wire that is coming out from behind us. If you have a thin wire, you can actually use the effect called Simple Wire Removal inside After Effects. But if your head is moving around too much and the cable is too thick, we'll need to manually mask that out. You can do that inside Premiere Pro, but it's not so user-friendly. I would really suggest here to use After Effects for this. I'm working on the source clip and have a mask around the cable. With the animation enabled for that mask, I adjust every frame. A lot of work, and afterwards we knew that we just should have wrapped the cable with a green cloth, so that we could use the Ultra Key on that as well. Looking back on it, a helicopter might have been easier. But you know what? We were very creative, and that's the most important thing with whatever you do. Stay creative, guys.
We got to get away! Get away!
Ik voel me helemaal Harry.
Harry!
Inderdaad, Harry, wat je aan het maken bent.